All right, let me get the commentator in here. Hello.
Hello.
How you doing? How you doing?
Pretty gay.
Me too, thanks.
Nice.
All right, let me give you the rig cam.
All right, I gotta password. Load that shit up. Oh, I already have. Nice.
There you go.
Is it now? Okay.
It will be. Mark my words. Also, the volume's too loud. There we go. All right. So, Sif4XG and MGGG. Sif4X manager, give me your instructions. I have a paste bin from Monster Girls. Let's see.
Oh, yep. There it is. The two at the back.
Yep. It's pretty good memes.
The unbeatable.
Who can stop two at the back, quite honestly? Although it's not my favorite two at the back, it has four in the midfield, 4-1. Two DMFs, I don't know about that. Oh yeah, conditions, there you go.
And one of them is red, so that's fine. And,
there you go. And are you alive, MGGG manager?
Nah, he's too busy fapping to Monster Girls.
Look, there's a time and a place, and you can do it when the game gets started, alright?
Why not now?
Because I need them to give me instructions. Look, part of adulthood is knowing when to fap and when to wait a couple seconds.
Alright, so... see what we got. I could see Hack starting for Civ. Maybe Miriam.
Well, Civ, both of them have really good keepers, actually.
Yeah,
Counter and Great Wall both feeling it. Even Hyperlane's feeling it. Is he he is a goalkeeper as well, so
Civ have a choice.
Mm-hmm.
If anything, you probably want to stick with a wall. I mean, putting a wall in front of your goal is a perfect way to not letting shit.
I guess MGGG isn't alive right now, but alright, Sif4X has some subs. They want Ecstatic out for Wololo.
Hey, Wololo!
Wololo. Hey, yeah. Darker Pleasures out for Hack Hack Hack, yep.
Who the fuck does not love the Age of Empires 2 sound clips?
That was like my first Heaven Games for Age of Kings was actually my first internet community ever. In like 2000. I was like 13.
You're old.
I am
Jesus.
Old.
Nice.
That's it for Sif4X, alright.
Oh, you have someone in commentary, I think.
Oh, someone...
Someone's in the waiting room.
Oh, okay. I can get Markod in here. Hey, Markod.
Maybe he didn't want to be in now.
Well, you could toss me in if you want to. I don't think I was planned for this one, but...
No, I don't know. You were in the...
I'm in the waiting room.
So, why not, I guess. But, let's see.
All so, right. Yeah, Markod, give us your best Wololo.
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 That'll do. It'll get better as the game goes on.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Also, would someone if I'm going to be doing this, would someone be giving me the...
Rick,
I'm
about to do that. Yep. And then... Bet. Alright. MGGG starting preset 2. And manually sub in best conditions. So there's a lot of them. Let's see. Yep, not that one. Not that one. Not that one. That one. And that one. Let's put it on the right.
That one.
There we go.
We did it.
Well, let's
see. Did it.
You have
let's
one
see
more.
How this group is actually set up, because that's relevant. Oh, yes.
This one is interesting.
It's the 4-3-2-1. Yeah.
Yeah, RLG on 4, Civ on 2, MGGG on 3, and AOG on 1. So I pretty much think it's win and you're in there, both these games.
Yeah, well, I think there's potential for some shenanigans with draws, but that's about it.
I don't want to think about. I don't want to think in general. Let's just get this game going.
Yeah, I think we're good. Just check. Oh, I have to do set pieces real quick, and then we'll be good, pretty much. Oh, for the CBs. Whoop. All right, I gotta undo this. Undo that. And undo that. It just says best conditions for the CBs. Leave Nero and normal human mage on. If they're not purple, they aren't. And then have the AMF on both corners. AMF. AMF. And that's it. All right.
So those bronzes not really feeling it, but hey, it could come into play. Blue's not the worst.
I believe this is a situation where you just want the player to play.
That's also always an option. If this might be your last match of the tournament, and you've got a player that you want to see play, but they haven't played yet.
Put me in, coach.
Sorry, tell me what stadium you would prefer, then. I can get you the World Ball. We got the World Ball in. Orbital Ring. Oh, yeah, that's right. I remember that. There we go.
Oh, yes. The Orbital Ring, pretty appropriate for Civ 4X type games.
Mm-hmm.
Nice, yeah.
For a lot of games, having that kind of tech would be the end game. For some of it would be the starting point.
It is the start, yeah. The difference between Endless Legend and Endless Space.
A favorite of many, the Orbital Ring. Nice stadium.
Alright, you got World Ball. These kits are probably fine. That's probably better.
Nuclear Gandhi looks ready. He's got his flags and his head.
Mm-hmm. Alright. I got the music already ready to go, so let me make sure Senpai is reading this. It is. Alright, cool. Let's do it. Civ4XG versus MGGG.
Let's go.
Did you know leaking the script ahead of schedule is in violation of United States law, and violators can and will be prosecuted.
FBI, open up.
Implying we care. Well, in fact, what actually happens, we'll say about after the intros.
Alright, we have the judge judging these two teams that his team went against. But, alright, here's some anthems. Alright, here we go, with Civ4X kicking off.
Nice. Baba Yetu, always great to hear.
Yeah.
Yeah, just, you can't hate that song.
Mm-mm. And, oh, they keep it in, actually. Keep it right on that touchline. Nuclear Gandhi recovers it! Misses Horatio! Stalin! Stalin gets it in! After some defensive spaghetti, he gets it in!
Somehow, I got the goal!
Well, that was silly.
What? That's an interesting start. The first 3 minutes, already we have complete mayhem.
Stalin doesn't give a fuck if the goalkeeper's in the way. He charges forth.
What an unfortunate
not one step backwards,
CB.
Comrade.
Well, that was an early start for SIFRXG, and we're at 1-0.
Oh, that's such an unfortunate clearance for that CB. Just straight back to Stalin, and in it went. Couldn't counter that one.
Yeah, I thought that was going to get cleared. It went. It looked like it was trying to get to Horatio Sauce. That's way too far out for someone. Yeah. I'm the bad guy. But it looked like it was going for Horatio Sauce, but he wasn't spinning fast enough to catch it. But thanks to that clearance, the Stalin could get to it.
So it slowed down a little bit now. There is no Horatio Sauce there.
The Monster Girls, can they actually set up a solid build-up? Because we haven't seen it so far.
They're trying
but early in.
A little bit, but they're slow to... Yeah, it looks like they're revving up.
It is still early, but Civ is just happy to press.
Oh, this looks good.
Oh, Spaz is able to get to the ball, and a one! Sets it by the wall!
It's in!
And just like that, we're tied. It's 1-1. Civ4X want to go to their... Whoop, a foul. God damn it.
Oh, we'll have to wait for that.
Oh, and Gandhi's down!
Oh, that's an injury.
Up, straight yellow.
Straight yellow. Gandhi's down for the moment, possibly.
Player shouting objection. It's getting overruled. There's the yellow, and the medics have been summoned.
Yeah, that was the totally ordinary human made.
Not sure how you apply first aid to a nuclear bomb.
Preset 2.
Well, very carefully.
And plus 1. There you go, SIFRX. You're on your preset
wow,
2.
Plus 1 already.
Plus 1. Yeah. He says they gotta go for it early, so...
That's only regular injured. He'll be back within a few minutes.
Mm-hmm. He's gonna get a bit of mental support.
Whoa! What a one shot! What a fucking unexpected blooter by Stalin to get a brace. It's 2-1. Alright, those changes coming into immediate effect for SIFRX, and they take another one.
That did not take long at all.
Yeah, who doesn't like more Red Alert music?
Wololo, careful, there he is, he's fine.
A tiny little bit on. Clutch there, but Wololo is able to put it out for a throw-in.
That shot going straight over Ukraine and into the net.
Oh, the wall!
Oh, that's dodgy! Oof.
That was dangerous. That could have been very dangerous for Sivrek's his keeper to do that. But his defense is there to pick up the slack. Now they're going on another attack over to please do not bully the Riftborn.
Oh, wow.
For being wide.
Well, it's a bullyable offense.
Yeah.
Go to preset one. All right, Monster Girls. Absolutely disgusting. There you go, preset one.
Oh, four shots on goal already for Civ. It's only 22 minutes.
Oh, here's Edo 1 trying to get it over, but it's intercepted by the defense. Cheap Papa isn't able to get it.
To say that Monster Girl Quest aren't getting chances.
Oh, Horatio! Oh, the sauce! Try something cheeky, but the defense is there. Messes them up a bit.
Enough just yet.
That was ambitious. He wanted that ball and he took a shot, but it was wide. The defense messed up his aim a little not much. Yeah, there's a lot of close misses so far. We're only 24 minutes in.
Sif with the more dangerous offense, especially when you make mistakes like that.
Well recovered.
Yeah, that could have just been if that ball had been controlled after that bounce, it could have been really dangerous. But here's another effective setup.
Well, Lolo, once again, able to cut out the attack and give it to the keeper to clear.
Clutch.
Fucking priests every time. They probably just converted that player into a Civ 4X player.
And Gandhi gets his revenge a little bit. Kick up the Arrow 1. Arrow 1 dispossessed by Sid Meier.
Sid's been doing pretty well as the last line of defense.
Balance for multiplayer. Picks that ball up on the wing. Coming up towards the box. Horatio Sauce tries to backheel it to Stalin. But it's put out for a throw-in. Balance for multiplayer.
Well, balanced on the line pretty well. That's a
he
corner.
He gets a corner.
Yeah, that's pretty tactical.
Please do not bully the Riftborn.
Well, does he deserve it this time?
Popping up somehow. On the bag, got caught by counter.
Oh.
That was on target. Damn. From that far out.
Well kept out. That probably kept MGG in this game.
Another through ball up to Arrow 1. Needs some support. Totally normal human mage tries to race for it, but it's cut out by the defense, and it's out for a throw-in.
You say that would close out the game, but we're still just over two-thirds into the first half.
Yeah, it's a lot of game to go.
There is still a long way, but that's safe, keeping them within one at least.
Yeah, staying fairly close in score is very relevant. Because that bullshit comeback of three goals, you don't see that very often. Especially not in this mess compared to certain earlier versions.
Yeah. That was good.
And that reminds me of old Hammy games.
Ah, yes. Never forget the 6-5s. The multiple 6-5s.
Yeah, there's two of them and a 5-4, if I remember right.
Yeah. Cheap Papa coming
good
up the
times.
Wing. Giving it to Arrow 1. Arrow 1 trying to get around Sid Meier. Nice move. Over to Dried Fish. Dried Fish dispossessed by Dosh Lords.
Can't handle the dosh.
They're fighting for it. Gives it way back to the keeper. Bounce for multiplayer. Steals it away. Giving it over somehow
dangerous.
The bad guy. Slips it past the keeper.
Somehow he's a hat trick.
Somehow I'm the hat trick guy. It's 3-1. right, well, we have a concession for MGGG.
Oh my god, 7-4 for Civ, and 1-1 for MGG.
Yeah, MGG, they had some pieces built up, but they weren't quite getting near enough on the finishing. They, like, the last defenders were just there most of the time. And on the other hand, Civ4XG have made a lot of very cheeky attempts on goal. Just blitzing past the last line of defense, stealing the ball in the opponent's half of the pitch. Something needs to change, but I'm not sure what.
Alright, so you want totally not... they've switched to their preset 3, which requires some subs. Alright, so... you've got Lolafina or Yellow Seaman for your left back.
That looks more like an orange seaman to me.
A little bit.
Whatever it is, it doesn't look healthy.
Oh, he's fine.
Right. You should probably get it checked out.
Eat more fruit. Alright, Voronin you want for an RB. So that's Robot Pope.
Other Cloakas. I think also RB.
Oh yeah, Cloakas. That works. Oh, you want Robot Pope. Alright. No, wait. All right. Okay. do you want this set two in RB? I imagine you do. Because it's a center back right now.
Makes sense that he draws it in position, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, right back. All right. I think everybody else is in position. So is that it?
Ooh, and yeah, apparently right. Stalin, like, he didn't do much before this, but apparently he's finished his great purge and now shit is getting rolling.
Shit is getting rolling for Stalin. Yeah, he really hasn't been that present overall until this match. Take off, swarm the box, and add Gigan. There you go. Anything else? And go. Thank you. All right. So those subs will come on. We've got a little bit more of this first half left. Alright, MGGG taking the kickoff. Dried Fish putting it way up for Ilias. Hack, hack, hack actually misses that. Ilias picks it up, puts it in the box, but Chi-Pa-Pa wasn't in position yet.
And do they have enough for a counter? They're not exactly good in terms of numbers, but Stalin is in position for a run down the middle.
Player trying to get it up to Stalin, but Counter is able to punch it away. Tosh! Oh, Lord, that's wide.
That was interesting. Wow, I think my no replay. Okay, thanks, Pez.
No replay.
Counter must have just hit it away because, well,
Civ4X are going to get the last attack. Balance from multiplayer killed. Hack, hack, hack picks it up. Please do not bully the Riftborn. Gets bullied, and that's the end of the first half. 3-1.
Okay, MGG was another lucky escape at the end there.
That was very exciting. All right. Nothing in the half for MGGG, and I don't think Civ probably won anything. God. Who can defeat the Invincible 2 at the back?
It just keeps happening, doesn't it?
If you don't get to the defense, two-man defense, the two-man defense doesn't need to stop you that often.
All right, right into the second half with Monster Girls kicking off. There's Spaz Dried Fish kicking it up for Ero 1. Wololo once again marking properly and getting it away. Over to the keeper to clear.
In terms of the group stage, this does confirm Civ.
Yep.
MGM Monster Girl Quest have got, well, 45 minutes to get at least two.
Oh, and that's a corner, I think. For them.
Yeah, they need a draw at the very least.
Otherwise RLG at least will pass them by.
Yep. Gently is able to head it away. Hack, 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 coming to pick it up.
A draw won't put MGG through, but it won't kill them after this game. But this result does at the moment.
Mm-hmm. Wololo gets bullied a little bit, but he's able to recover it and give it over to...
A draw would get them through as long as RLG wins or draws the next game, I think.
Yeah. Basically, AOG winning kills anything.
Balance from multiplayer. Nuclear Gandhi, long shot, but it's right to counter Sands.
If he failed to grab, that would have been a bounce.
And wow, alright.
Well, the heavy pressing seems to be putting Siv under a bit more pressure, but
well, that was a free ball just yet. There, but Spass just kind of stopped and the other two strikers weren't there. That'll be a corner.
Yes, that's a corner. Yep.
Check corners. Up. Sure.
Make sure you got the right people taking him.
Yeah,
with a major formation change, that's
the manager just really quickly said check corners, so I caught it, but he says they're good, so. Popped into the air.
Oh, hold on, it's
Nero wide.
Yeah.
Yeah. Great Wall gets it over to Sid Meier. Fuck with.
Just a. Would you?
Would I? I don't know.
It depends which
I'm
gonna
one. Need to think about it.
Very much depends which one.
Yeah. Somehow I'm the bad guy, gets over the rip. Born Horatio Sauce is gonna pick it up. Can't quite control it. The defense is able to get it to the keeper to clear.
Do you mean the game developer or the busty dead girl? Pick one, and only one.
Do I?
Oh, that could have been dangerous. Oh, that's a foul against us.
Yeah, yeah, so. It's a foul against, but
that was close.
It just fucking collided.
And just drink the sauce.
The Sif4x manager says he'd fuck both, by the way.
Nice.
TBH.
Good taste.
We're going to stop for subs in about a minute and a half.
Horatio Sauce just wanted to give that player a piece of potent Horatio Sauce.
Oh, here's the real question.
Let's resolve this.
Where's our Johan?
That'll work. Alright. Monster Go Games, you have one sub left. What would you like? And Sif4x, when would you like subs, if not now? And check offensive sliders. Alright. Your offensive are counter long center flex. All right, time out to set it to maintain and go to six. There you go.
Keep everyone in position. The fluid bringing the forwards up. Could see them create chances, especially with the counter long. Those nice quick attacks, but they need to get them off. They haven't been doing so as of late.
Hack, 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 coming out for Oshaka.
Oh yeah.
Oh shit.
It's time.
Oh, the priest, the priest is
no!
Going off. Yeah. He's been doing a good job, but he's getting sleepy, so this is a good change.
Maybe just create more priests after the game ends.
Get that religion.
Yeah, you don't
want
to go, you don't want to try destructive anal against monster girls.
Mm-hmm. Check who's more tired between Wiz and Doshlores. Wiz is.
Are we saying fuck Wiz?
Paradox never. Paradox 3 never. 4. Part 3 was a mistake.
Yes, yes it was. Very much so.
Alright, and turn off fluid. There you go, and they're gonna go plus 1. And Wiz is coming off for the Sisters of Milkies.
More boobs coming on.
Monster Girls are good. Anything else for you, Sif4x? Just to confirm. When your minor faction is defined by a set of tits. Implying. All right. Otherwise, roll it. Alright, you're on plus 1 now, Monster Girl Games.
Unless your minor faction is defined by something looking nice.
Unbelted Nero is able to clear it out for a throw-in.
Yeah, that was dangerous. They had to go for a clear as quick as possible there.
Balance for multiplayer, getting over to Horatio Sauce. Nuclear Gandhi putting it way over for Doshlore's Dried Fish with a nice tackle. Sister
Milkies
can't hold on to it.
A lot of attackers here. More attackers than defenders.
Did nothing wrong trying to find Spads!
Oh no, the diving header just never works.
I love a good failed diving header.
Three attackers against two defenders. All you had to do was just get past them, and they just couldn't do it.
Well, it is Spats. Erewhon tries to get her head on it, but it's out for a goal kick, I think. No, it's a corner. The defender got his head on it. Lovafina caught by the Great Wall.
Time is ticking away. 18 minutes.
Yeah, that two-goal lead looks a lot more dangerous now than it did earlier in the match.
Dried Fish with another nice tackle. Gives it over to Spats, trying to get over to Erewhon. Putting it way up for Ilias. Oh, Ilias cut blocked! Oh, I thought he was going to catch it, but he blocked it with his fists. And it worked out for them.
Oh, and this is another aggressive move.
Oh, the Riftborn. The Riftborn gets around. Horatio Sauce!
Oh, Horatio!
That is the dagger, I am fairly certain. It is 4-1. You gotta play that horn till the end.
Yeah.
But there you go, it's 4-1, and I don't think there's any saving Monster Girls at this point.
No, they do say that we've only had one case where a 3-goal lead was completely wiped in a matter of minutes, but I think it's...
Oh, please do not bully the Rip Park!
Could it be 5?
Bullied the fuck out by the keeper!
Very close!
And they're just going on another assault.
When you ask the police, no bully.
Somehow I'm the... Horatio Sauce gets a brace! And it's welcome to Spain, boys. Okay. I'm gonna play this one. Concession again, just to turn on all-out defense for Monster Girl games, and that's it.
Stop the bleeding.
Stop it. Yeah,
there's still 10 minutes left, so it could get... we could go to Brazil if things go really badly, but...
Oh, it's Erewhon getting a brace!
Well, there we go.
Comeback's on! It's 5-2. We'll Sivrek's going to the preset 3 because fuck it.
Yeah, why not? 7 minutes, you got a 3-goal lead, do whatever the fuck you want.
Yeah.
Well,
I mean,
perhaps not do that. Picking up cards is still something you probably don't want to do.
Yeah. Well, actually, they're getting wiped after this.
Yeah. Well, so but the suspensions don't if you just get suspended this match.
There are still suspensions, and you know, Sif could
The bad guy is wide.
No, he's done for the day. He's
no double brace.
Ukraine. He's gone home. Yeah, Sif could still end up in the survival bracket.
They could, I mean, this guarantees them through in some way, but...
Yeah, they will probably want as least yellows as possible to save that suspension, but I don't know.
And we're doing rankings on the survival round in terms of where you play by
You might just get more goal difference and get a better spot in seeding.
Yeah, you might get a bye or not.
A +3 in 5 points does put them in a pretty good spot. That is a fairly high score for second place teams. So they could just go straight through to the second round.
Yeah. 4 minutes of stoppage. Great Wall just kicks that away. Chipapa, get it over to Edo1. Spats.
MGG, get another
amount of room.
Maybe.
Give it over to Edo1. Yeah. Blocked out. Edo1. That'll be a corner.
Oh, why? Spats should have just taken the shot.
Trusting Spats to take a shot, please. You saw that diving header.
I've forgotten about that.
Yeah. Alright, we'll take this corner, Lolifina.
This might be MGG's last chance for a consolation goal.
Oh, Shaka just headbutts that away. Stalin picks it up. And it looks like the last attack is going to be Sif4X's.
Unless the ref
does he have any support, though?
Not especially,
he doesn't look like he does.
That should be it.
No, that'll be it. There it
5-2 for Sif4X, and you have guaranteed yourself at least to the survival round.
Yep, should they end up in the survival round, 5 points plus 3-goal difference, probably will see them straight to the second part of that survival bracket.
Yeah, there's 4 teams for that, I believe, so...
4 teams. Not many can get over... 5, I believe there is still a 6-6-6-0 group left that could happen.
Well, there is 1 6-point team already confirmed for survival group, that being Alter.
Yeah.
Yep, there's
They're
one.
They're probably getting a bye. Alright, you got a custom victory anthem. Alright, no problem. Sif4X. I mean, they earned it from these stats. 13-8.
Oh, yeah, they did.
5-4.
Yeah. So you could just say that this game just completely wasn't balanced for multiplayer.
No.
It was balanced for multiplayer, but they just got out-fucking-skilled.
Mm-hmm.
Oof.
Man of the match. Somehow, I'm the bad guy with an 8.
Somehow, I'm the man of the match.
Alright. Match details. 3 minutes. Somehow, I'm the bad guy unassisted. 14 minutes, Arrow1.ogg from Spats. 15 minutes, Totally Normal Human Mage got a yellow. 17 minutes, Somehow I'm the Bad Guy from Balance for Multiplayer. 43 minutes, Somehow I'm the Bad Guy from Balance for Multiplayer. A couple of subs came on for MGGG with the preset change. More subs at 68. 78, Horatio Sauce from Please Do Not Bully the Riftborn. 82 minutes, Horatio Sauce from Somehow I'm the Bad Guy. And 84 minutes, Arrow1.ogg from Ilias Did Nothing Wrong. That's it.
Yep, 3 goals and assists. That'll easily cement a man of the match and an 8-0 for Stalin.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. Bit light on the left wing on the Sif4XG, but...
Yeah.
And then you can just see from those ball-winning areas just how MGGG just couldn't get the attack off. There's so many ball-winning areas right by the net.
Mm-hmm.
2 at the back. Last line of defense is very effective.
Yeah, Wololo and Sid Meier really putting in work. And who's the other one? Dude Science Lamau. All putting in good work as CBs for their 2 at the back line.
Well, one of them you can just literally convert other players to your side, so...
Yeah, that's true.
That's probably one thing
that tends to help.
Alright, well... That'll do it for this match. And we're going to move on to our next match, the second one for Group A. And that is going to be Roguelike versus Ace Attorney Online.
Okay, so from that, any win will put... Actually, I think... Yeah, no, this is that's the groups now shut out. This match literally means fuck all.
Does it?
No, actually.
No. AOG
because
can...
it's a 4-point team versus a 1-point team, but there's a 3-goal swing. So AOG need to win by more than one.
Yeah, they need to win by two or more. And AOG would go through over RLG into the second round. Second place.
And AOG are missing a non-metal defender.
That's not the end of the world.
Quality rips. Rip it.
So a 3-goal win for AOG will put them into the survival bracket, and Civ 4 will go through.
Even a 2-goal win, they need to win by at least 2.
It's at least 2, okay.
Because the team there after surpassing goal difference is what they're playing against, so every goal counts as 2 effectively.
And any other result? A draw for RLG also puts Civ straight into the round of 16. Any other result? We'll see. Roguelike top the group.
Yep. Alright, well...
Cool. Good old group stage math. We can get that out of the way.
Mm-hmm. We'll see how this pans out for these teams in the next match. But thank you both for commentating.
My pleasure.
Yeah.
Bye-bye.
See you later. Alright, let's play this special anthem of Civ 4 X's. Ooh, alright. I know this song.